Let's now go to Peter Fitzsimons to talk Aussie politics, former Wallaby course and now author, broadcaster and commentator. Greetings to you, Peter. What is going on this week? What is going on? Have we seen a big shift in Australian politics to the right? Let's get right to the crux of it, eh?
That's a very good question. We Australians want to know exactly that. What is going on? We went from, you know, you go back from the early 80s, Bob Hawke was there for 10 years, Paul Keating there for 3 or 4 years, John Howard for 10 years, and then suddenly, bang, 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 Kevin Rudd, Julia Gillard, Tony Abbott, back to Malcolm Turnbull, back to Scott Morrison. I mean, I think I probably missed one out there. It's just gone so quickly. And this one was so rapid. I mean, about a month ago, Malcolm Turnbull was 49-51, two-party preferred. The pressure was on Bill Shorten, and it really looked like Malcolm Turnbull might be coming back. Then Thursday, about eight days ago, suddenly there was the word, no, there's a challenge on. And before our very eyes, there was a tiny trail of smoke, and then it just, boom, and it just burst into flame, and it raged for 3 or 4 days until suddenly we've got a new Prime Minister.
What do they want? What did the Dutton Conservative camp want? What was the problem?
Well, it's very interesting. There was a brilliant piece written about this in the Sydney Morning Herald 2 or 3 days ago. As a matter of fact, I wrote it. Funny you should say that. And my theme was, when Malcolm Turnbull came in, he had the role that I have now, chair of the Australian Republic movement. You know, he was the former chair of the Australian Republic movement. He was somebody that was not left of centre, but he was certainly on the left-hand side of the Liberal Party. And there were people on the left who looked at Malcolm Turnbull and said, climate change, he'll take action. Refugees, he'll be humane. Indigenous relations, he'll be good. Same-sex marriage, he'll push it. Republic, he'll push it. So there were 5 or 6 things where Malcolm Turnbull, though he was a Liberal, he looked progressive, and he could have led, instead of leading the Liberal Party, he could have led the extreme centre party, because that was the way he was positioned. But in the course of his Prime Ministership, the problem was, it seemed to those of us, I guess I'm on the progressive side of politics, he seemed to be constantly appeasing those on the far right, and no action on climate change, dismissing the Uluru Statement for Indigenous people, doing not much at all for the Republic movement. He turned up for 2 hours at one of our dinners, which was fabulous, but he wasn't seen to be moving. So he had the problem that those of us who were wanting him to be progressive, well, he was disappointing us, and those on the right were looking at him saying, well, you're actually a lefty, aren't you? And so he was not pleasing either side of politics. All that aside, I repeat, a month ago, he was still within 2 points of Bill Shorten, two-party preferred. And the other problem is, on those polls, when he came in, he looked at Tony Abbott, pointed at him and said, this man has led this party, this government, to 30 successive news poll defeats. This cannot go on. So he was the one that set that bar. If you lose 30 in a row, you're in real trouble. You've got to be replaced. Well, he got up to 38 and then he was replaced.
So Morrison, tell us about him. And for New Zealanders, and this is an issue you've obviously done some great work for the Sunday program on, around deportations, immigration. Under Scott Morrison and this new regime, are we going to see any change, any softening of immigration laws or deportation laws?
I suspect that is unlikely. I suspect it's very unlikely. And you say, what is Scott Morrison like? I'm an Australian. I read politics. I love politics. I follow it every day. What do I know about this man? The answer is, like most Australians, not that much.
He's got a Kiwi grandparent, doesn't he?
He's a very strong Christian. I think what they call them... he must be... Is there a chance of dual citizenship?
Well, apparently.
But we know he's an... He's an evangelical Christian, so we know that about him. He's a family man. I supported him very early on. Alan Jones, the former Wallaby coach, back in 2007, was viciously attacking him, saying, this fellow Scott Morrison wants to come into politics, I don't want him. So I wrote a piece in the Herald, look, if Alan Jones is attacking him, he's got to be a good man. And he seems to have been a competent treasurer. Well, in fact, you'd probably say he's been a very good treasurer, because, you know, our economy is going very well. But the abiding image of Morrison over the last four or five years, the one thing that he did where Australia looked at him and went, oh, what? He brought a lump of coal into Parliament and said, there you go, there's coal, you beauty coal. Now, in Australia, there's a huge discussion taking place. There are various elements of the Liberal Party who just say, well, climate change is not happening, you know, and we shouldn't take any action whatsoever on climate change. And that has been the issue that Malcolm Turnbull first lost his leadership of the Liberal Party over. And in essence, it's one of the ones that he's lost it over this time. So there we have Scott Morrison, new Prime Minister. He's come in. That's the image, lump of coal. Now, for many Australians, me included, I look at coal and I say, I don't know what the future looks like, but it doesn't look like coal. So he looks, in that place, he looks sort of very reactionary. Also very interesting that the first public pronouncement as Prime Minister was, I've invited Donald Trump. Now, we look at, you what? Donald Trump's coming here in November. It's, as a political move, it seems to you ask which directions he's heading. Somebody said to me today, that was a lump of red meat to the Conservatives, I'm with Trump.
But so are they
really
done for?
Don't know. I mean, to be fair to Scott Morrison, he seems like a decent man. He's obviously intelligent. He was a competent treasurer. So we're going to give him, in Australia, we fancy, we'll give a fair go. Maybe he'll prove to be one that can unite the Liberal Party. But the problem he's got, less than winning the election, 6 months away, is really to unite the Liberal Party, which has been fighting like two cats, maybe three cats, in a sack for the last week. And there's been serious articles written by serious people saying this is an existential crisis. Can the Liberal Party go on?
Will people in Australia, the punters, give up on politics? Is that the danger here? Do you start to see extremists like your One Nation growing in support because people are so fed up with your mainstream centrist politicians scrapping?
One Nation is, I'm trying to think of that expression, I remember, a hopeless, embarrassing schmozzle. Schmozzle, complete schmozzle. And we in Australia are very lucky to have that kind of politics led by Pauline Hanson, because if it was run by a serious operative that really knew what they were doing, they'd go from 10 points to 20 points. They'd actually start to, you know, maybe gather some power. As it is, while Pauline Hanson's running it, it's a total schmozzle.
It's a pressure valve.
But you are seeing a splintering on that right-hand side of politics, because you've got Corey Bernardi from South Australia starting, I think it's called the Australian Conservative Party. You've got Pauline Hanson with One Nation, who used to be with the Liberal Party. Corey Bernardi used to be Liberal Party. Bob Catter, mad as a catter. Bob Catter used to be a National and is now with the, whatever it is, the Catter Party. And, I mean, he had this extraordinary thing the other day where his senator came in and used the words final solution in his maiden speech, and Bob Catter was cheering it on. And most of Australia just looks at that and says, you are kidding.
No,
but
thanks.
That is all, Peter, on the far right. It's all splintering.
Peter, we have to leave it there. Peter Fitzsimons, thank you very much for your time. And I stuck to my word. I did not mention the rugby, but thank you very much for your time. We do appreciate it on Q&A. Very good. Right.
I've barely cleared my throat, but thank you.